Hachette Audio presents The Running Grave, written by Robert Galbraith, read by Robert Glenister. When, like a running grave, time tracks you down. Dylan Thomas, When, like a running grave. It took a long time for things to go so far. It came about because things that should have been stopped were not stopped soon enough. The I Ching, or Book of Changes. Prologue. All individuals are not equally fitted to consult the oracle. It requires a clear and tranquil mind, receptive to the cosmic influences hidden in the humble divining stalks. Richard Wilhelm, Introduction to the I Ching, or Book of Changes. Letters between Sir Colin and Lady Ensor and their son William. The 13th of March, 2012. Will. We were appalled to learn from your personal tutor yesterday that you dropped out of university and joined some kind of religious movement. We're even more astounded that you didn't discuss this with us, or bother to tell us where you were going. Unless we're being lied to by the woman who answers the phone at the headquarters of the Universal Humanitarian Church, handwritten letters are the only means of contacting members. She gave me her word that this letter would be passed to you. Your mother and I don't understand why you've done this, why you didn't talk to us first, or what can have persuaded you to abandon your course and your friends. We're extremely worried about you. Please get in touch immediately you receive this. Dad. The 16th of April 2012. Darling Will, the lady at the church headquarters says you've received Dad's letter, but we still haven't heard from you, so we're still very worried. We think you might be at Chapman's farm in Norfolk. Dad and I will be at the New Inn, Routon, this Saturday at 1 p.m. Please, Will, come and meet us so we can talk everything over. Dad's been doing a bit of research on the Universal Humanitarian Church, and it sounds like a very interesting organisation with worthy aims. We can certainly see why it would appeal to you. We aren't trying to run your life, Will. We really do just want to see you and know that you're all right. With lots of love. Mum. Kiss, kiss, kiss. Dear Will, yesterday I visited the UHC's Central Temple in London and spoke to a woman who insisted that our previous letters have been passed on to you. However, as you didn't come and meet us on Saturday or send us any word, we have no means of knowing whether she's telling the truth. I therefore feel it is necessary to state for your benefit or for the benefit of whoever might be illegally opening your mail that I know for a fact that you're at Chapman Farm, that you never leave it unaccompanied, and that you've lost a substantial amount of weight. I also know that it's impossible for anyone except members of the church to visit the farm. You're a highly intelligent individual, Will. But the fact remains that you're autistic, and this isn't the first time you've been manipulated. Unless I hear back from you by phone or in a letter written in your own handwriting by the 5th, I will contact the police. I've been in touch with an ex-member of the Universal Humanitarian Church, whom I'd like you to meet. If the church has nothing to hide, and you're remaining at Chapman Farm of your own free will, they can have no objection to you meeting us, or speaking to this individual. Will, I repeat, unless I hear from you by the 5th of May, I will contact the police. Dad. The 1st of May, 2012. Dear Colin and Sally, thank you for your letters. Everything is fine. I am very happy in the UHC, and I now understand many things that I never understood before. In fact, I am not on the spectrum. That's a label you've attached to me to justify the levels of control you've exerted on me all my life. I'm not your flesh object, and unlike you, I'm not motivated by money or materialist considerations. I understand from your last letter that you've been having Chapman Farm watched. I'm an adult. And the fact that you continue to treat me as an infant who should be spied on just proves how little I can trust you. I also know exactly which ex-member of the UHC you want me to meet. He's a very dangerous, malicious man who's done harm to many innocent people. I advise you to have no more contact with him. The drowned prophet will bless all who worship her. Will. The 2nd of May, 2012. Darling Will, we were so happy to get a letter from you, but we're a little bit concerned by it because it really doesn't sound like you, darling. Will, please meet us. If we can meet you face to face, we'll be reassured that you're happy and know what you're doing. That's all we ask, a face-to-face meeting. Darling, I want to be completely honest with you. Dad did have somebody watching Chapman Farm because he was so worried about you. But I promise that's all finished. Dad's cancelled the arrangement. Nobody's spying on you and we don't want to control you, Will. We only want to see you and hear from your own lips that you're happy and that you're acting of your own free will. We love you, and I promise we only want the best for you. Mum. Kiss, kiss, kiss. The 12th of May, 2012. Dear Colin and Sally, I will meet you at the Central Temple in Rupert Court, London, on the 23rd of May at midday. Do not bring anyone with you, especially any ex-member of the church, because they won't be admitted. The drowned prophet will bless all who worship her. Will. The 24th of May, 2012. Dear Colin and Sally, I agreed to meet you yesterday to prove I'm completely happy and fully in control of my own choices. Both of you demonstrated high levels of ego-motivity and were disrespectful to me and abusive towards people I esteem and love. If you contact the police or start having me watched again, I will bring charges against you in court. The church has arranged for me to be assessed by a doctor who will testify that I have full capacity and that you are the ones trying to exert undue influence on me. I have also consulted the UHC's lawyers. My trust fund is my own, and as Grandpa left me that money, not you, you have no right to prevent me from using my inheritance for good. The drowned prophet will bless all who worship her. Will. The 16th of March, 2013. Darling Will, I know I say it in every letter, but please, please contact us. We understand and respect the fact that you want to remain with the UHC. All we want is to know that you're happy and well. Most of all, we'd like to see you in person. It's been over a year, Will. We miss you so much. I sent your birthday present to Chapman Farm. I hope you got it all right. Please, Will, get in touch. Nobody's going to try and persuade you to leave the UHC. All we want is your happiness. Dad deeply regrets some of the things he said when we last met. We aren't angry, Will. We just miss you desperately. Dad's going to add his own note, but I just want to say that I love you with my whole heart and simply want to know that you're okay. Mum, six kisses. Will. I sincerely apologize for what I said about the church last year. I hope you can forgive me and that you'll get in touch. Mum misses you very much, as do I. With love, Dad. Kiss. Extracts from a letter from legal firm Coolidge and Fairfax to Mr. Kevin Purbright, former member of the Universal Humanitarian Church. The 18th of March, 2013. Private and confidential legal correspondence, not for publication, broadcast, or dissemination. Dear Sir, this letter is written on the understanding that you are responsible for the blog Exposing the Universal Cult, which you write under the name ex-UHC member. Blog post of April 2012. The Aylmerton Connection. On 2nd of April 2012, you published a blog post titled The Aylmerton Connection. The post contains several false and highly defamatory claims about the UHC. The opening paragraphs read, "Unbeknownst to the vast majority of its booming membership, who've been drawn to the church by its message of equality, diversity, and charitable service, the Universal Humanitarian Church was born out of the Aylmerton community, a notorious Norfolk-based commune, which in 1986 was revealed as a front for the paedophiliac activities of the Crowther family. Most members of the Aylmerton community were arrested, along with the Crowther family, but those who were lucky enough to escape prosecution remained on the community's land, which they rechristened Chapman Farm. This diehard group would become the founding members of the UHC. Any reasonable reader would understand by this that the UHC is, in effect, a continuation of the Aylmerton community under another name, and that the UHC's activities resemble those of the Aylmerton community, specifically with relation to paedophiliac activity. Both assertions are false and highly defamatory of our clients. Furthermore, the phrases lucky enough to escape prosecution and die hard group would suggest to the reasonable reader that those who remained on the community's land.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.